Hi! In this video, I will show you how to make a simple face mask. It is a step-by-step tutorial. We will start in Autodesk Meshmixer, where we will make 3D face object. Next, we will use Fusion 360 for some additional tweaks. And finally, we will slice the model in Cura. All along the video, you can find several tricks for mentioned programs and even some suggestions towards the end. So, let's get started! Welcome to my YouTube channel GreenEyedExplorer, where I explore further and beyond about tweaks, hacks, electronics and house repairs. These are programs I use almost every day. Today we will use two Autodesk programs, Fusion 360 and Meshmixer. So just let's start the latter. Both are the latest version on February 2019. First we will click Import Plane. Here it is. It will set our work bottom plane. Meshmixer has many preset scalable objects. We will select heads. The one here has proven to be good for face masks. We drag and drop the head to the center. Be sure to set the size to 1. You can check other options, but they just distort the model. Click Accept. Now click Edit and then Transform. As the head is rotated, we will adjust the rotation in the Z axis and enlarge it to real size. After rotating, don't forget to scale it up 10 times. The uniform scaling should be checked below for human faces. Aliens may vary. And now the model is gone. Oh no! We just have to zoom out as we are currently inside this guy's neck. Here's our Baldy. As his nose is a bit high, we'll also tilt his head forwards. Click Transform again. The line from tip of the nose to the ear should be horizontal. Now we will cut our mask out. No surgical equipment, just click Plain Cut. This blue arrow shows which part will be cut. If we drag the red arrow around, we see where the plane is. Now I will move the plane around a bit like a real pilot. The nose of the mask should be opened at the bottom. Here's the trick. Fill type should be no fill, as we are making a mask, not an object. Next we'll cut the skull off, so the large blue arrow should point towards it. We will tilt it a bit as mask should be narrower towards ears. Surgical precision. Again select no fill, accept. Ears should also get away as this ain't no elf mask. Adjust the plane. As it will be 3D printed, it should lean forwards. Surprise! No fill again! And now let's finally see what do we have. A nice single layer mask. To select all the triangles, press Ctrl plus A if you use Windows. Under Edit, you will find Extrude. Or press D. We have to make it solid. Direction should be normal and density 100. Offset is the mask thickness. 2 mm is thick enough for any PLA not to break. Let's see why I have changed the direction. Constant is default. See, it makes edges unprintable. So normal it is. Now we just have to export the model and this is how to do it. Now we will move to the other program, which is Fusion 360. If we want to import STL files, we have to turn Design History Capture off. Here is how to do it. Click Continue. Under the Insert menu, we click Insert Mesh. Find our previously saved file. Here are some options. I advise you to click center and move to ground to ease further steps. Let's measure the mask. It fits me and my kids, so I hope it will fit you too. Wait a bit, it's just a few clicks away. It is 14.6 centimeters wide. So if we want to see, we'll have to cut some holes for eyes. But before advancing, we'll have to make a solid body from triangles. Right-click on Mesh Body 1 and select Mesh to B-Wrap. It will make a solid body and make it visible. Now we can turn the design history capture back on. Right-click on the first line. Click the ladder option. It appeared at the bottom. Eyes. We will create a new sketch. Select the ZX plane. I'll draw two ellipses. I have decided the width should be 40 mm and the height 20 mm. Don't mind the violet rings, they are anchors to the mask. I'll turn the mask visibility off now that we have ellipses. Press D to select dimension tool. Set dimensions like I do it here, on both sides. The left eye is a bit tilted. We'll have to adjust it. Under the Modify menu, there is a Move tool. You can also press the M key. Arrow snap, so I will enter the number. 0.5 mm. Let's rotate the object to see where our drawing plane is. Behind the eyes. Now we will actually cut out holes. Click Extrude above. First click one, then press Ctrl on the keyboard and then click the other one. Drag the arrow up a bit. If we turn the object visibility back on, the Extrude menu on the right changes to cut. Now you will see why it is good to turn Design History Capture back on. Do you see the lateral right eye corner? A small sharp remnant. Let's use lower toolbar. Double click the last extrude icon. It returns us back a bit. The reason for remnant is the sketch plane. Let's cut backwards a bit too. Mind the direction change in the menu. Well, this was a basic surgical procedure. To export the model from Fusion 360 and open it in Cura, one way is to right-click on the unsaved line at the top and then save as STL. The Cura version I have is 360. I will show you another trick. If the model is not flat, you will use a lot of support filament. This is not an ideal model to show you this, as we have plain cut the model and leveled it in Fusion. See, I have supports enabled. Well, the trick is to lower the model under the bed. This part will not be sliced in Cura and not printed afterwards. The other thing I would like to advise is to select at least 3 lines wall thickness to make the print sturdy. The mask will be printed in around 3 hours. Appendix. Suggestion number 1. It is useful if you make some holes for the elastic around the head. Here is how to do it. We'll use Fusion 360. Select Side View. We'll make a new sketch. Select ZY plane. We will draw a circle.
A great location would be about 40 mm on y-axis and 30 mm on z-axis. I'll hide the mask to prevent snapping. Let's see the location. It's great. Now let's dimension it. Press D on the keyboard and click the circle. Diameter of 3 mm should satisfy. We just have to extrude it. Symmetric extrusion. Now drag the arrow through the mask. It automatically clips. Click OK and that's it. Suggestion number 2. If you do not like snapping to grid in Fusion 360, you can turn it off. Here's a grids and snaps menu. Just uncheck the snap to grid. Now it's easier to draw face ornaments. It will just try to snap to the edge of the selected triangle. Fin and the end.
So, I have shown you many tricks in both Meshmixer and Fusion 360. You are invited to hit the like button below to support my work. Comment below if you have any thoughts. Do subscribe to my channel and share the video. Support me even further. There are links to PayPal and Patreon. Either way, you can download a finished face mask model from my Thingiverse page. All the links are in the description below.